A very good morning, children. In the last class, I had completed lesson 5 from your supplemental reader book, that was Footprints Without Feet. And let's proceed with the next chapter from the same book, and the name is The Making of a Scientist by Robert W. Peterson. So before commencing the chapter, let me introduce you a little bit about this chapter. Actually, this article is an account of a curious child who was channelizing his curiosity to become a scientist. And his name was Richard H. Ebright. He is one of the leading scientists, and he has contributed significantly to biochemistry and molecular biology. Okay, and Ebright's journey began by collecting the butterflies. Okay, so what all he did and how he became a great scientist, that we will come to know from this chapter. So be with me and try to understand the lesson thoroughly. Okay, so I will be reading, and as you know, we will be discussing the difficult word meanings, and I will be explaining the chapter in detail. So coming to your book, children, just see The Making of a Scientist. Richard Ebright has received the Searle Scholar Award and the Skirring Plough Award for biochemistry and molecular biology. It was his fascination for butterflies that opened the world of science to him, as I told you in the beginning itself. Now coming to the lesson. At the age of 22, a former scout of the year excited the scientific world with a new theory on how cells work. Richard H. Ebright and his college roommate explained the theory in an article in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science. Means what? Here, Richard, who was a single child to his parents actually, so at the age of 22 years only, at a very tender age, okay, what he did, he just caused the excitement in the world of science by what? By his new theory on explaining that how cells work. Cells, you know very well, in the biology you have learned this term, children. Cells are the very smallest unit of the living matters, isn't it? So he brought the theory in front of the world about how cells work. And he was a former scout of the year. Scout of the year here means he was the member of an organization earlier, and then he caused excitement in the whole world on his new theory. And Richard H. Ebright and his college roommate, one of his college roommate was there, they both explained the theory in an article. Okay, this article was published where? In this journal, that is the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science. Okay, next, it was the first time this important scientific journal had ever published the work of college students in sports that would be like making the big leagues at the age of 15 and hitting a home run your first time at bat. For Richard Ebright, it was the first in a long string of achievements in science and other fields, and it all started with butterflies. So now, this was the first time ever it happened that the most important scientific journal, whose name was Proceedings of the National Academy of Science, it had published the work of the college students. Okay, means Richard H. Ebright and his roommate, they were the college students. Okay, when they got their theory on how cells works published in this very important scientific journal. And if we talk or compare it with the sports, okay, so what we come to know, that that would be like making the big leagues at the age of 15 and hitting a home run your first time at bat. Leagues, you know, the matches, okay, that takes place means the groups of teams when they play the matches among themselves, that is the leagues. Everyone of you know, as the you are watching the cricket match and all. So when at a very tender age, it is mentioned at the age of 15, when someone hits, okay, the six at the first ball itself with the bat, that how that player will feel. In the same way, this Richard Ebright was feeling when his article was being published in that very famous journal. For Richard Ebright, it was the first in a long string of achievements in science and other fields. Okay, so it was really string means here a line, means he had achieved many other works in science and all other fields, but this was the first in that long line of achievements. And what was that? It all started with the butterflies. He had started experimenting on butterflies. An only child, Ebright grew up north of Reading, Pennsylvania. There wasn't much I could do there, he said. I certainly couldn't play football or baseball with a team of one. But there was one thing I could do, collect things. Now, what Richard Ebright further says that he was only child of his parents, okay? He was a single one. And where he grew up in one of the place called as Reading. In which place? Pennsylvania, and that is in USA, okay? So, the Reading is the name of the place. And he says that in that place, he didn't get much scope to do anything more work related to science. So, certainly, even he couldn't play football or baseball with a team of one. He was alone there. He was without friends. Okay. And therefore, he says that he couldn't play this football or the baseball because it needs a team. So, if he was alone, he can only do one thing, that he could collect the things. As you know, many of you have the hobbies of collecting some different things, okay, and keeping. So he also just acquired that hobby of collecting the things. So he did, and did he ever. Beginning in kindergarten, Ebright collected butterflies with the same determination that has marked all his activities. He also collected rocks, fossils, and coins. He became an eager astronomer too, sometimes stargazing all night. Okay, so that was the only thing he could do to collect the things. So beginning in the kindergarten, you know very well, school for the small children, KG classes, you have heard, that is only kindergarten. So when he was in KG classes, okay, from that time he had started collecting the things. And first of all, what he started collecting? Butterflies. With determination, means he was firm for the purpose to collect the things. And he started doing activities with all such things. Not only butterflies, he also took interest in collecting the rocks, different types of rocks, then fossils. Fossils are the prehistoric remains, isn't it? Remains of the dead bodies of plants and animals. So, he started collecting that, and even the coins. Okay, and he became an eager astronomer. Astronomer is the one who studies about the planets, sun, moon, etc. So, he was really a very curious person to learn about the planets even. And for that, sometimes the whole night he used to gaze at the stars. Gaze means to look keenly, very intently. He used to look in the sky up above the stars and all. And he became even an astronomer. See, it is given about here what is the meaning of home run. A home run in the game of baseball is when the batter scores a run, after running safely around all the bases and back to the home plate without stopping. A ball hit out of the playing field is also called a home run. Getting a paper published at the age of 15 in a scientific journal is here compared to scoring a home run while batting for the first time, as it was explained to you earlier. Next para. From the first, he had a driving curiosity along with a bright mind. He also had a mother who encouraged his interest in learning. She took him on trips, bought him telescopes, microscopes, cameras, mounting materials and other equipment, and helped him in many other ways. So what happens here? From the first onwards, okay, he had a driving curiosity with her, means really he was a boy with a bright mind. He was very intelligent one from the childhood onwards, and that only made him curious to learn more and more new things. Okay, means that curiosity only helped him to drive his mind from one thing to another. And who was his first teacher? Obviously his mother, who encouraged him, okay, by seeing his interest in learning the things. So she started taking him on the different trips to different places, okay, new places, and even just provided him telescope, you know, an instrument to make distant objects appear nearer, isn't it? And then microscope, just opposite of that, instrument for making the small objects look bigger. So all these different instruments were provided to him by his mother. Then cameras, then mounting materials. What do you mean by mounting materials? Means the equipments to be put on the pedestals. Okay, means all these equipments needs the stands na to keep that. So these were also provided, mounting materials and other equipment, and helped him in many other ways. Okay, so his mother, when she knew about her child's interest, she started encouraging him a lot by providing him many different types of equipments and instruments. Next, I was his only companion until he started school, his mother said. After that, I would bring home friends for him, but at night we just did things together. Richie was my whole life after his father died when Richie was in third grade. Okay, so who is saying these words? Yeah, Richard's mother. So she says that she was the only friend, okay, until Bright went to school. As he was the only child, so there was no one else at home, his mother said. And after that, she started calling some of his friends for him, okay, to get the companionship at home. But at night, they both were only there at home to just do all the new experiments and activities together there. Richie is the here the nickname of Richard Bright. Okay, and the mother says that Richard was her whole life, means her whole life was completely devoted only for Richard. Why? Because Richard's father had died when he was only in the third grade, that is in the third class. She and her son spent almost every evening at the dining room table. If he didn't have things to do, I found work for him. Not physical work, but learning things, his mother said. He liked it. He wanted to learn. So now what she further says that during the evening time, okay, every evening what they used to do, they both, Richard and his mother, when they used to sit at the dining room table, okay, so when Richard never finds anything to do, then his mother used to find out some or the other new activity to be done by him. Not the physical work, not to be done with his body, but to use his mind. Okay, but she used to give him the activities related to the brain work for learning the things. Okay, and really Richard also was great too much interested in that. He was taking great interest in doing all such things because he wanted to learn new things. He never denied anything for that, and learn he did. He earned top grades in school. On everyday things he was just like every other kid, his mother said. So the mother is really appreciating her son here by saying that really that boy took great interest, with great determination he used to do all his work, and he always was getting the top grades in the school. He scored the highest ranks in the school, and on everyday things he was just like every other kid. Means he was in all other matter, he was like the all other normal children only, but his intelligence was quite more better than all other children. By the time he was in the second grade, Ebright had collected all 25 species of butterflies found around his hometown. See, when he was only in the second grade, means in second class, he had already collected 25 different species of butterflies which he found around his hometown itself. Okay, nearby his house he found. And see, the table is given over here, species and the subspecies of butterflies collected in 6 weeks in Reading, means the place where he used to stay. Reading, it was in Pennsylvania. So these are the names of the different species of butterflies which he had collected. Altogether 25 species of butterflies he collected when he was in second grade. That you can read it. After that, probably would have been the end of my butterfly collecting, he said. But then my mother got me a children's book called The Travels of Monarch X. That book, which told how monarch butterflies migrate to Central America, opened the world of science to the eager young collector. Okay, so after that, when Ebright couldn't find many more species of butterflies, so he thought that that would be the end of his collections of butterflies. Okay, but after that, his mother, he brought a children's book, a story book called The Travels of Monarch X. Okay, that book was monarch is a kind of butterfly, actually it is also one of the species. So that book was brought and given to Ebright by his mother, and that book which told how monarch butterflies migrate to Central America. So in that book he learned that how these monarch butterflies, they migrate means to move from one place to another, isn't it? So how they just move to Central America, it opened the world of science to the eager young collector, and that created him more curious and eager to learn more about that monarch butterflies. Okay, to the eager young collector here is, he was the collector, means who was collecting the butterflies, we come to know that. Okay, so here he was again interested in doing the same. At the end of the book, readers were invited to help study butterfly migrations. They were asked to tag butterflies for research by Dr. Frederick Urquhart of the University of Toronto, Canada. Ebright's mother wrote to Dr. Urquhart, and soon Ebright was attaching light adhesive tags to the wings of monarchs. Anyone who found a tagged butterfly was asked to send the tag to Dr. Urquhart. Okay, so what was given at the end of that book, which was provided by his mother? The readers, whoever reads the book, they were asked, okay, for what they were entrance, they were invited to help the person there named Dr. Frederick Urquhart, okay, to study more about the butterfly migrations, that how it occurs and in what way they were asked to help further for studying about the butterflies migration. The readers were asked to tag the butterflies. Tag means to attach the labels, as you are labeling your books, new books when you purchase, in the same way one label was to be attached on the butterflies, okay. Who was doing the research work on them? Dr. Frederick Urquhart, okay, who was the professor at the University of Toronto, Canada. So he had invited the readers to tag the monarch butterflies for research purpose and just send it to fly. Now, Ebright's mother wrote to Dr. Urquhart, and soon Ebright was attaching the light adhesive tags to the wings of monarchs. So Ebright's mother also, she only directly wrote to Dr. Urquhart to involve Ebright in carrying out this experiment over the monarch butterflies, okay. And Ebright also, he started attaching the light adhesive tags. Adhesive, you know, sticky thing, you are using the adhesives to stick the things, that only the tags were being attached to the wings of the monarchs, okay. And anyone who found a tagged butterfly was asked to send the tag to Dr. Urquhart, and it was mentioned there that anyone, whoever finds that tagged butterfly, they were asked to send that that tag to Dr. Urquhart, so that he may carry on the further experiments about that, okay. So after that, the butterfly collecting season around reading lasts 6 weeks in late summer. If you are going to chase them one by one, you won't catch very many. So the next step for Ebright was to raise a flock of butterflies. He would catch a female monarch, take her eggs and raise them in his basement through their life cycle, from egg to caterpillar to pupa to adult butterfly. Then he would tag the butterfly's wings and let them go. For several years, his basement was home to thousands of monarchs in different stages of development. So it is mentioned that there is one particular season, okay, of collecting the butterfly in that place where he used to stay, that is in Reading, and it was during the late summer. In the last 6 weeks only, it was a season to collect those butterflies, okay. And it was also said that if anyone is going to chase, means to follow the butterfly, if they are running after the butterflies to catch them, okay, they won't be able to catch many butterflies because they will fly away. So now what was the next step for Ebright? It was to raise a flock of butterflies, okay. Flock means the group of butterflies. He don't have to catch one by one butterflies, but now he had to collect in a group. And he would, for that, what he would do, he would catch a female monarch. For that purpose, to get the group of butterflies, first of all he had to catch a female monarch, and then after taking her eggs and just raising them in his basement, okay. Basement means that his underground construction only in his house. So through that life cycle of the butterfly, from the egg, okay, it will raise to caterpillar. From caterpillar, it will grow into the pupa. Pupa is the early stage of a butterfly, okay. And then it will grow into an adult butterfly, that is the fully grown butterfly. So this whole process will go on, and then after getting the adult butterfly, Ebright could tag the butterfly's wings and let them go, okay. So for several years, his basement was the home to thousands of monarchs. So for many more years, he carried on the same work, okay, of raising the butterflies, and to thousands of monarchs, and he used to prepare monarchs in different stages of development. Means he started developing the monarch butterflies in different stages. Okay, so here one table is given, the number and kinds of butterflies collected in the 6 weeks. Okay, so let me stop here, children, for today's class. I will continue in the next class. Till then, goodbye and have a nice day.